Jack Viney, ladies and gentlemen. Keith Bluey Truscott Memorial Trophy winner for a second time, a 2024 trophy to go with your 2016 trophy. How does this one sit? I dare say you're in a little bit of shock.
I am. I am definitely in shock, just like the Demon Army. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I'm shitting myself right now. I'm shaking. I'm a little bit nervous making this speech and chatting to you, Clint, but I know you're going to look after me.
I will. I do every time. Jack, this is a story of... I mean, you played every game this year, averaging 21 touches, 6 tackles, 4 clearances throughout. We know you have a hunger to improve and improve all the time. You have a hunger generally. What is it that's motivating Jack Viney right now?
Yeah, I think it's success. I want to be part of another premiership. We've touched on a fair bit tonight, but they're so special. But I think I understand the hard work that goes into making them happen, and it's about the team. How do we best make the team function? What are the roles within that? And that's just what I want to put my heart and soul into. Whether that's try and make myself a better player, whether that's being able to help teammates or contribute in any kind of leadership capacity, I'm all in because I want to win another flag.
So you mentioned the word leadership, and it's a role you share as VC with Max, who, by the way, 5 votes in this count this year. It was incredibly tight. What is it about that partnership that brings out the best in both of you?
Yeah, I've absolutely loved working with Max for a long time now, and I think it's a massive credit to Max, the amount of pressure I think that captaincy puts on him and him having to front up week in, week out. Not sure you guys have been reading the papers, but there's a fair bit going on at our footy club, and this man steps, puts his shoulders back and fronts it all, and then has to find the energy to perform to the level he does. I think it's an astonishing, and we're so lucky to have a person like Max, and I'm so thankful and grateful to work alongside him.
So cast your mind back to when you first won Bluey in 2016. There was no premiership and there were no kids either. Life's changed for Jack Viney now. How busy is the Viney household?
Yeah, no, it's definitely changed from a few years ago. I'm not going to lie, this year's been at times trying to find, get to game day with my best self and energy, energy battery full. The kids certainly drain that. So I have a lot of thanking to do to my beautiful wife and also my family at home. I do believe in that saying, it takes a village to raise a child. So I got a lot of support at home. So, come that 2 hours on the weekend, I'm the best version of myself, ready to give it my all.
We heard from Max just before. He spoke about resilience and the journey, as did Goody as well. Is it something you subscribe to as well? It's been a month now since we finished playing in 2024. What's going to set this group up for success next year?
Yeah, I think, Goody and Max have touched on it. It's about how do we unite as a team? How do we galvanise as a club? And I think it's not just the players, it's not just the coaches, it's everybody from the fans in the stands to the players. I think we need to galvanise as a football club through this adversity and become really proud of the red and blue. And it's not about wins and losses, it's not about premierships, it's about being proud of what we produce every single week, and I'm looking forward to doing that. I've been fortunate to be involved in a few, a lot of discussions through this off-season, putting things in place about how do we make 20 for 25 an epic one, and I'm extremely optimistic, and I can't wait to get stuck into it. I've been able to train with a few of the lads already, and I can sense that hunger in the belly. We've touched on 2019, how... we got to that end of that season. There was this sense of embarrassment and being ashamed of what we did. And I think I sense a similar feeling amongst the group now. And we want to be better, and we want to put in the hard work. And I can feel that hunger to do what's required.
What? One more from me, and before I let you thank your nearest and dearest. So you've re-signed until 2028, which is pretty big news for the Melbourne family. Does that mean that your old man Todd has stopped calling you?
No, Dad's my number one supporter, and he's his club's number one supporter. He just wants to see me succeed, see this team succeed, and he's. I think in recent years he's seen that this club's in good hands, and you know he's just been along for the ride. So no, he can't wait for us to tackle 2025.
Well, we are in great hands with this man's leadership. A few words from Jack Viney, your winner of the Keith Bowie Truscott Memorial Trophy.
I'll try my best. To not forget anyone here, but you know, I want to start with my coaches. You know, obviously for turning me and sculpting me into the player I am. You know, Mini, this year I've loved working with him, and I wish him all the best at West Coast. He's going to be sorely missed. You know, even you know Sammy Radford as well, Reece Conker, these guys I pester on you know Demon Days, trying to do my my midfield craft, trying to get me primed and ready for game day. So, you know, these guys do a lot of things outside of their roles to try and make me better. So I'm really appreciative of that, and it's gone into, you know, a lot of, you know, making me the player I am today. You know, I'd like to thank Alan Richardson, mate. You know, our relationship over the last few years, it's been really special to me. You know, there's been times when, you know, I've really probably felt like I've needed some feedback, some stern feedback about where I'm at. And you know, I've really trusted your advice, so it's meant a lot to me. To my players, you know, you can't win individual awards without the help and the connection of your teammates. So I want to thank you all very much, and I look forward to getting to work, putting a big pre-season and creating something special for next season. To my family, mum and dad, my brother Max, I can't explain to you the support that you've given me over my career, and I'm sure I'll thank you face to face. But to my wife now, like I said, it's hard work at home. I really enjoy going to work every single day because that's the easiest part of my day, and coming home it's a shit show. So you know how you are. How you do that full time, I'm amazed every single day, and you're an absolute trooper, and you know, you allow me to sacrifice time and energy and to become, you know, put it into my football. I can't thank you enough, so thank you and love you very much. I think it's a bit of a running joke, but I think my first BNF speech I won, I forgot to thank her, and she hasn't made me forget about it, so I'm glad we remembered her tonight. You know, to the fans as well, you know, thank you so much for all the support you guys give us throughout the year. Coming to the footy, the Demon Army, it really does, it really, I know you guys are the front line, but it really does make all the difference, you know, like Nibba spoke about and Brownie spoke about tonight, just the interactions and the support. The confidence that gives us, the motivation that gives us, it really is a game changer. So I can't thank you enough. And I guess just, you know, finally touching and capping off on 2024. Yes, it was a disappointing one, but I think through this adversity, we're going to come out the other end stronger. And I can't wait to make 2025 a really exciting one that you're all going to be proud of. Thank you.
Want to see more from the D's? And don't forget to subscribe up here.